afternoon, everyone. Have you ever wondered what games your parents or guardians used to play? Really think about it. If there were no smartphones or tablets, what games did they play? Did they play video games? Oh no. They played outdoor games. Before these electronic devices, your parents, grandparents, uncle, aunts, cousins, and guardians used to play outdoor games among themselves. There were a variety of games such as hand clapping games, ring games, marble, stone games, skipping games, ball games and other games that required a lot of skill and creativity. Did you know some old-time games had African sounds and rhythms, while others had a mixture of African and European flavor? And some were silly. They were played just for fun. Let me introduce to you three games they used to play. Please remember to let your parents or guardians assist you with creating and playing these games. Our first game is called Footsie. What do you need to make and play this game? First, you need a small bleach bottle, string, and a nail to bore a hole in the bottle cap. First, you have to cut the bottle at the section where the neck meets the long area of the bottle. Then you bore a hole in the cap with a nail. You insert the string under the cap, and then you're going to knot the string under the cap to ensure it doesn't come out. Before you cut the string, you'll need to lengthen the string at a reasonable length to allow the players to tie the string around the ankle. The string around your ankle must be loose enough so that it can spin around the ankle. This game can be played by as many persons as you wish, or even one person. The object of the game is to see who can jump the longest without stopping. Let's play. Our next game is called Pick Up Stones. You have to concentrate, observe, and you're going to have to be very quick to play this game. All you need are 10 small or medium-sized stones. You first find your 10 stones, and then you must gather those 10 stones in the palm of your hand, either your right or left, depending on whether you are right-handed or left-handed. You'll then have to throw these stones up in the air, but not too high, because you'll have to make sure one of the stone lands on the back of your hand. The stone on the back of your hand must be thrown in the air, but not too high, since you must catch it. With the one stone in your hand, you must pick up the 9 other stones on the ground, one at a time. You repeat from the beginning, but this time you must pick up 2 stones at a time. You'll continue with 3 stones, then 4 stones, etc., until you have to pick up the 9 stones all at once. Thank you. Our next game is called Marbles. You will need a tennis ball, chalk or colored tape. The chalk is used for concrete or stone surfaces, while the colored tape or masking tape can be used for tiled surfaces. You'll need to make a large rectangle that can be divided into 8 squares. Each square must be large enough for your foot to fit into, with some extra space. Also, each square should be numbered 1 to 8. First, you'll stand outside the rectangle and roll the ball into the square numbered 1. The person rolling the ball must stop the ball in the square numbered 1 before it touches the line or goes into the square number 2. Note, if you stop the ball when it touches the line or is in the square number 2, you are out, and it is now someone else's turn. If you stop the ball before it touches the line or goes into the square number 2, then you hop the ball once in each square from number 1 to number 8. The ball is then rolled into the square numbered 2. You must step into the square numbered 1 and stop the ball before it gets on the line or gets into square numbered 3. In the square number 2, you will need to hop the ball twice into that square and once into each square from number 3 to number 8. Note, if the ball is stopped in the line separating the squares or in the square that is not the one you're trying to get the ball into, you'll proceed to square 3 and then hop the ball 3 times and 1 into each square until you have reached square numbered 8. After square number 4, the game gets interesting since squares number 5 through 8 will be on the opposite side of square 1 through 4. You need to stand at the square numbered 1 and roll the ball to square numbered 5. You must run or walk as quickly as possible to stop the ball in the square numbered 5. Then you can roll the ball diagonally from square number 1 or roll the ball in from square number 8, but you must get the ball in the square numbered 5 and get there before it rolls out, regardless of which method you use. Once you have stopped the ball in square number 5, then you can hop the ball into the square 5 times and once into every square from 6 to 8. The game is finished once you have safely rolled and stopped the ball in all the squares from 1 to 8. At square numbered 8, you're given the opportunity to pick one of the squares as your win. No other player but you can jump into it. If any other players jump into the square, they will be out and someone else gets a turn. Remember, there are now 3 ways that you can be out while playing marbles: when the ball is stopped on the line, when it goes outside the square you're trying to stop it in, or if you run, walk, or jump into the square another player has claimed as their own. Hope you enjoy the games that were played in the old days. Do not forget to ask your parents or guardians about the other games that they used to play, and remember to place that information in your journal. See you next time!